هناك شريرة أليها لضيفنا يا هبة غيرة
Thank you.
so gar nicht, ne?
Hare Krishna, we have with us our, in a way, very kind sponsors from Namdari Gurudwara. Those who have been coming for several years know we have been offered by them a wonderful facility in which to receive Srila Gurudev. It's very difficult to find a place with a proper kitchen, with pure standards of no contamination from meat. It's very difficult to find a place where many, many people can sleep and bathe and do all their bodily necessities and bhajans. And even they're experiencing their Guru Maharaj is just had an operation and they were engaged in bhajan for his well-being, and still, because they've committed the temple to us, this temple room, still they're letting us use. So their kindness, they're more than brothers. They're more than brothers to us. And we very much appreciate their presence. Just as a word of information, we had tried to secure a larger place close to the town center, and at the last minute it became more and more evident to us that the construction work would not be completed on time. That same place where we had the program, there's a big church hall that's being renovated, and devotees started noticing that they were falling behind on the construction. So we thought, Krishna, we'll call our Sikh brothers to the rescue. And at the last minute, we had to change all the messages on the internet service. And for them, no problem. Oh, you want to come? We will make all arrangements for you. Because they're not only letting us the facility, they actually have a deep appreciation for our Guru Maharaj and for the process of Nam Sankirtan. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce the president, Mr. Chana. If you would please come and say a few words, because from all the faith communities, we appreciate them the most and they appreciate the most. So please, Hare Krishna.
I'd like to say Sat Sri Akal and Hare Krishna to everybody who's come to Birmingham and stayed here at our Sikh temple. Like my friend, my brother said, you are always welcome whenever you want to come here and be a friend. And I'd like to apologize for any inconvenience close to you during your stay here, because like my brother said, we are engaged with our Sadhguru not very well and we couldn't spend much time here with you. So most of our Sangat has gone to London to say a special prayer today. So some of us just stayed behind to visit you today. And I'd like to say welcome to Holiness here as well. Thank you.
You know that all the Sikhs are Sanatanist devotees. And you know from the beginning, Guru Nanak, what meaning? He was Guru, to give transcendental love and affection for Supreme Lord. And in his dynasty, in Guru Parampara, Arjun Singh, we see there. And so many. Oh, there are first Hindus, still in Hindu. To save Hindu and Sanatana Dharma from the clutches of Muslims at that time, Mughal, Aurangzeb and others, very aggressive. Oh, he has a vow that if they will not defeat Mughals, and they will have to quit India then we will not shave our heads. We will not shave our ears. And they took some bow in their hands. They wear. You should see. Oh, yes, that. That will be bring independence for Hindu and Vedic culture. So they are not any separate thing from devotees of India. They are Sanatanist. They also know that Krishna and Ram is Supreme Lord. Guru Nanak used to tell all these things to his devotees everywhere. So they slept everywhere. Arjun lost his two sons because they promised, we cannot accept Muslim religious. And they were given in wall was constructing. And the Mughals, they put him in that wall. Wall became here. Oh, you will accept? Never. Then here. Now you will have to accept. Never. They came to here. Oh, there is some time. Otherwise you will cover. But he still did never accept and he was given in war. So how sacrifice they have done for India to save Sanatan Vedic Dharma. So we are also here in their guidance and they should save us and give shelter so that we can preach Sanatan Dharma in the land of Chaitanya. Guru Nanak, that Krishna and Ram is super. They are Supreme Personality of God. By chanting and remembering Supreme Ram, we can be happy. Otherwise, never. So this is the mission of all Sanatana Vedic Dharma of Guru Nanak, Arjun Singh and his Guru Parampara. Still, but some mad Sikhs, they think that we are separate from Sanatana Dharma and we should fight for them. But so many intelligent and pious Sikhs, almost all, only some few like that, they want Sikhistan or it. But pure Sikhs always share Hinduism everywhere. So many thanks that they have given their shelter to preach our mission of Ram and Krishna, Gita, Bhagavata, Ramayana. My blessings to them and my prayer to Krishna that Krishna should be merciful to them. They should be happy. Gaur Pramanam. This is usually two words. Why we can? You. One day, in our 6 days, Mahotsav, you can bring your singers, party, they should come and do some kirtan. We want to hear. And thus we should exchange our views and everything. आप लोग तो हिंदी भी पूरी अच्छी तरह से जानते हैं, इसलिए उन सब लोगों को लाएंगे, कीर्तन करेंगे, हम लोग भी सुनेंगे, हम भी करेंगे, विचारों का आदान प्रदान होगा और हम लोग मिलजुल करते रहेंगे।
Om Agyanta Nidandasya Giranjana Salakaya Chakshura Nilitam Jaina Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. Srila Gurudev has asked me to speak a couple of words about why he has come here. And I know for all of you, anything I can say will simply be repeating the obvious, which is why you're all here. The reason that he's come here clearly is to continue the great tradition, the Sampradaya and the teachings of our Sampradaya, Gaudiya Vaishnavism, which is to reach out to the world and spread the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is love and affection for all living entities, and to give all living entities, irregardless of qualification or disqualification, the chance to attain prema, or pure love of God. This is the highest goal of life, the greatest gift that can be given, and it's our great fortune and a great rarity that a personage such as our Srila Gurudev has come and to inspire us. Many of us were at one time stuck in an ocean of melancholy. Many of us took initiation or inspiration from His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, my Guru Maharaj. He inaugurated the Hare Krishna movement. Now it's over 30 years ago, 33 years ago. 36 years ago. So it's been a very long time, and a lot of us have been waiting for this opportunity. We've missed Swami Bhaktivedanta's association, wondering where is Krishna? Is Krishna there for us? And Krishna has heard our prayers and sent his bosom friends, Srila Prabhupada's bosom friends, our dear Gurudev. And what more can I say than this, except that we hope that Gurudev continues to give us shelter at his lotus feet and continues to be patient with us and inspire us more and more to realize that the path to Krishna and the path to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is firm faith in the lotus feet of Gurudev. Without that, we are absolutely nothing and have no hope in spiritual life. Sometimes this is misunderstood. Now and then we hear about some wonderment about Guru Tattva, but the fact that Srila Gurudev is here is proof that Guru Tattva is there guiding us, looking after us, and ensuring that our path back to Godhead is guaranteed by their mercy.
Two, four words. Om Agyantra Hasya Jyam Jyam Shrakya Shaksham Netam Jinam Tasmaisi Kirae Nama. Oh, from here?
No.
Oh. Vali Yusuf.
Like that.
Yeah. Okay, Rajana.
Here on that.
This is very embarrassing. It's, let alone I don't feel qualified anymore. Panchakalpa Trudhu Sarayati Vasandhavirshtadam. Last night I was having a discussion with some of our Islamic friends in the shop at the custard factory, and I tried to make the point to them that Krishna explained the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita millions and millions of years ago, eventually to Manu, the father of mankind, and that the science of the relationship between the individual and the Supreme ultimately really has nothing to do with Christian, Hindu, Muslim, or Jew, because everyone is a spirit soul and has an eternal relationship with God, and the basic principle is bhakti, or love and devotion, like this. But one thing they accept, and all faith communities accept, that with time, and due to the nature of institutions, the essence of religion can be lost, or it can become corrupt. And unless a person who has 2 feet firmly situated in the spiritual world, we have one person with 2 feet in the material world, perhaps looking in the right direction, often looking in the wrong direction. Maybe someone else has 1 foot in the material world and is taking some help and has 1 foot stepping into the spiritual world. But unless we have the guidance of someone whose both feet, lotus feet, are situated in the spiritual world and who can pull us up, it's very difficult to understand the true purport of the scriptures. And it may take many, many lives to get that association. So we feel very, very fortunate after many, many millions and millions of lives in useless existence in this material world, simply trying to survive and thrive and eat, sleep, mate, and defend, and somehow or other, by some unimaginable agyata sukriti and good association, we come in the association of a pure devotee whose both lotus feet are firmly situated in the spiritual world at all times, and who kindly reaches down to us and pulls us up. So with all the humility at my command, I bow down to lotus feet of Shri Narayana and all of the devotees in this assembly. Hare Krishna.
Who works? Om Gyanati Mirandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chakshunvitam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakapadruvyascha Kripasindhubhevacha Patitanam Padanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. So I'll just speak very briefly that how fortunate we are that I cannot describe at least my good fortune of being able to be in association of somebody as kind and merciful as Srila Gurudev. We all feel how exalted he is, but being with Srila Gurudev since 96, from some moments, what has really stood out in my mind is how kind and how compassionate and how he overextends himself so much for us. And when I see it time and time again, I become bewildered, I become stunned, I cannot describe how amazed I am at his kindness and his compassion. So this, we can understand that this is the manifestation of the kindness, compassion of the Supreme Lord Himself, of Lord Krishna, Srimati Radhika, and the combined form of Radha Krishna, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So our great fortune we cannot measure. And we see Gurudev traveling all over the world. I was just in Badger, LA, San Francisco, and just by his presence, the atmosphere of Vrindavan that he brings, and the joy and the lightness. As soon as Gurudev comes with his devotees, then it is just ananda, just pleasure and just bliss. And without this, actually, there's no real value to life. From time to time, I come in contact with people all the time who are not having such association, and I feel so sorry for them. And coming from that situation, then I come into Gurudev's entourage, and it's like coming from darkness to light. More than darkness to light. It's just so pleasant, so pleasurable. And devotees, people, they see that, oh, those who are with Srila Narayana Maharaj, that there's something different. There's something different in this group. But what it is only Srila Gurudev. Without Srila Gurudev, then we're nothing. And everything, all the bliss, all the happiness, all the special moods that are there, that they're only due to the mercy of Srila Gurudev and Guru Parampara. I was saying the other day that somehow, just as one devotee, Matiladish Prabhu, he was saying in Bajra, we were discussing, and he was saying how Srila Gurudev is the embodiment of all the Guru Parampara. That all the personalities in the Guru Parampara, that they're there within the body of Srila Gurudev. So, what can I say to glorify somebody as exalted and so merciful and kind as Srila Gurudev? So we're very, very fortunate to be here. And I pray that we somehow or other always be with Gurudev, if not physically, but at least by heart, and get closer and closer and closer so that we can be specks of dust in the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev.
ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नन्ने गौरत्विषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातर्याजुहां पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेतु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानुतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न ज्वामि तया विना इति विख्याराधे तन्नय मां चरणम् At first, by humble obeisances in the lotus feet of my Paramaradhyatam Gurudev, Om Vishnu Vasishma Bhakti Pratyan Kesho Goswami Maharaj, and my Shiksha Guru Om Vishnu Vasishma Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, all the Tetanvi Padgan, Vaishnava, Vaishnavigan, my dear mothers, sisters and all. As they told, we have come to remind you that you are part and parcel of Supreme Lord. We have forgotten Him. He is most powerful. He can create in a second, in a moment, millions and millions of universes. And in the same time, in a second, He can demolish all, and again millions of universes. He can create very beautiful, handsome, sweet, and very merciful. It's very, very for us. Very, very. That is why He sometimes descends from Golok Vrindavan with His all associates. And sometimes He sends His very powerful associate to remind us that you are all part and parcel of that Supreme Lord, an eternal servant.
Without His mercy, you cannot realize your transcendental form, never, and you cannot be happy. There is no way to be happy. This world is what? Full of miseries and very nashvara. Very sad. Very soon we will be old. And too old. And then we will have to give up this body. What we are collecting from this world, money, position and everything, you cannot take. Even a single hair. You are not this body, physical body. Don't quarrel for this. Don't worry for this body. This is a bag of urine, stool, blood and so many things. Soul is there, eternal. And he has been captured by Maya in this body. You should always realize. Very soon, whether you want or not, you'll have to give up this body. Only the bad actions and good actions that you have done, or it will go with you. And again you'll have to come in rotation. But when you will surrender yourself in the Lord's feet of a very qualified bona fide guru, sadguru. And if he will obey me and obey his instructions, then very soon you will realize, oh, we are in dream, what we are seeing, looking for here and there. We were in jail. And now they will see in a moment, for they are in Guru Vrinda. There is no birth and death, no endless pain of birth and death there, no old age, nothing there. Huh? Only serving of Supreme Lord and always sinking in the ocean of endless and deepless ocean of love and affection. So, our rishis and maharshis, they realized this fact millions of years before this thing. Especially Krishna and Ram, they came to this world. And to Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Ramayana, Vedas and Puran, all that we are eternal servant of Krishna. His obit is embodiment of love and affection. Krishna especially. So you can realize by all these things by reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Vyas, He divided Vedas. He manifested so many Purans, Mahabharata, Gita, so many Upanishads he discovered and manifested, but he was still not happy. Once Narada, his guru, came and asked, why you are looking worried? You know everything and you have written, but still you are unhappy. He told that, my Gurudev, I don't know. Please tell me why I am worried. A disciple should surrender in the lotus feet of Guru in such a way. Vyasa is Narayan even. Yes, oh gosh, this idea. And then Narada told him that you have given preference of dharma, artha, kam, moksha and all these things. But we have not written the sweet pastimes of Krishna, that a Krishna can come, the Supreme Lord, in the form of a very beautiful son. He goes door to door in the houses of all the gopis to stroll bread, butter, not butter, heart. We cannot be worried for him because we don't realize, but he realized they are all my children. They are my part and portion. So he descends, we cannot go to him. Understand? We cannot go there. But he descends himself. We cannot call us earnestly, but he calls by throat. Come on, all. Dance with me, sing with me, and be happy. This is Rash. Have you written all these things in what you have written? Mahabharata, Gita, or Purans? No, I don't know all these things. How he serves his father, Nand Baba and Yashoda? How he is controlled? Even being the Supreme Lord, he forgets that I am Supreme Lord. And her, his mother, what doing? Chastising. I will not let you come in my laps. I will not give you breath. Then what you will do? Be there far away from me. To whom he is doing? To Supreme Lord. His. You know Shakhas? Subal Siddhan. Oh, they defeat Supreme Lord. And tell that you should be my horse. And then become Krishna becomes horse-like. And they ride on there, his soldiers. And you should run away. And sometimes, if their mothers have given any very sweetest thing, paraphernalia, preparation, oh, they took from their mouth and gave in the mouth of Krishna. How wonderful. So, have you written all these things? Have you written that Krishna is telling that, oh gopis, I cannot repay you. In thousand and thousands and billions of years, I cannot. Please be merciful to me. Oh Supreme Lord. He is telling that I cannot repay your what your love and affection. That you left everything, your position, your dharma, sanatana dharma, chastity, or the fear from their superiors, for Krishna. Krishna cannot, he cannot give up. Even one shahar bhakti then, he cannot give up his father, mother. He cannot give his queens of Dwarka. He cannot give up Arjun, him, Nakul. Even those who are chanting his names and taken his shelter, he cannot give up. But gopis, what they gave up. All top to bottom, everything for Krishna. So Krishna said, oh, I cannot. Have you written? No. Then what you have written? Nothing. And that is why you are not happy. Then how can I write all these things? Oh, be in trance. And by my mercy, in your trance, in meditation, you will say, be surrendered there. and take help of Bhakti Yoga. Bhakti Yoga means surrender. And thus he surrendered himself. And he saw in transit from birth of Krishna up to all the three pastimes of Dwarka. Especially the three pastimes of Gokul, Vrindavan and Vraja. And this is called Samadhi Bhasha, Srimad Bhagavatam. We, by this thing, Srimad Bhagavatam, we can know that Krishna is not our goal to achieve Krishna. But Krishna praying is our goal. But also you should know who is the reservoir of that praying. Who? Gopis. Among gopis, Chandravali and Radha. Among them too, they are reservoir of that covenant. So, our aim and object to attain that love and affection of Krishna. So, praying is prayojan. Prayojan means ultimate of our bhajan or goal of life. This love, and if you can attain even a glance of that love and affection, even a many part, then you can what to you can make it endless ocean of love and affection, and whole universe will be down there, and you will be happy. Krishna will be happy, and thus your life will be happy. There is no way. So everywhere I am speaking of this. From the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila, 3rd and 4th chapter. And Srimad Bhagavatam, from Brihad Bhagavatamritam, that our aim of our life and devotion is to attain love and affection in the guidance of gopis. The mood of Radhika, we cannot attain. Anyone, even Krishna, he was greedy for that. But we can attain something. That is had been told in Anarpita Charinshira. To serve Radhika in a manjari boat. This is the highest goal of our devotion by love. In our bhakti practice. But how to attain? Then we'll have come to dawn. From Adav Sadda, Tata Sadhu Sam, Tata Bhajan Kriya, Tato Anathan Vritti, Tata Nishtha, Ruchi, Ashakti, and then Bhav, then the Pralambha Bhav. And then after that, Sambhog Bhav pray. 8 stages which Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained in Bhajan Rahasya in 8 chapters. And these chapters are like this. Adav Sadda, morning of the hour bhajan. Morning. But it is called Nishant Lila. Now Nishant Bhajan begins from Shraddha. Second, Sadhu Sangha and Anartha Nivritti at a time. Without Sadhu Sangha, who has so many unwanted things on earth, it cannot go away. So we are weak because we are full of all kinds of anartha. But it may go only by the process of taking shelter in the lotus feet of sadhu. But sadhu, how? If a sadhu can deviate, then he is not guru. He never deviates. Because he is sadguru. He realized so. He has realized Krishna. he knows all the epic teachings as a very expert. He can remove all doubts. He has no doubt himself. Then, otherwise, those who are in doubt, what is soul, super soul, what is bhakti, how we can be happy, how can we serve? Oh, those who have no realization, even they have no ruchi, taste, then they cannot achieve. They are bound to fall down. So this guru cannot help you. Because these kinds of guru are dilemma. You see, and you have experience for these gurus. Really, if you want to attain that kind of love and affection in the guidance of gurus, you will have to take shelter in the lotus feet of any such rasik and bhav guru. And begin from Shraddha. We are told everywhere, what is Shraddha? Shivarani can speak two words for what is Shraddha?
Shraddha Shabde Vishwashakohe Sudrida Nischoy. That is, Shraddha is the firm faith that Krishna Bhakti Koila Sarva Karma Kritahoy. If I simply engage in Krishna Bhakti, all other subsidiary activities are taken care of. My maintenance, my happiness, everything else is achieved. How does Shraddha come? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu states, Ekupe Brahmanda Bhomite Konya Bhagyavanaji Guru Krishna Prashade Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. After many, many millions of births wandering in different universes, one who has performed many, many millions of births of Sukriti, spiritual pious activity of going to temples, serving sadhus, knowingly or unknowingly, observing holy days, reading or hearing spiritual shastras. After many, many births of this, one meets a bona fide self-realized guru and attains from him the seed of bhakti, the bhakti lata beej, that is Shraddha, which is the root of all devotion, ultimately leading to praying. There are two kinds of Shraddha, that is, Lokik Shraddha, or faith in mundane superiors, and Transcendental Shraddha, or faith in the words of Guru, Sadhu, and Shastra. Lokik Shraddha can also mean when one's faith in the words of Guru, Sadhu, and Shastra are komal, weak, and shaky. And when that faith becomes strong, it becomes paramarthik Shraddha. Paramarthik Shraddha, or transcendental Shraddha, is of two kinds. The first kind is called Shastra Artha Avatarana Mayi Shraddha. That is, when one's faith is inspired by the words of Shastra, that is, the instillment by Shastra that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I am His eternal servant, His part and parcel, and having forgotten Him, I'm suffering. So out of a sense of duty, I engage in faith in service to the Lord. Or out of fear. Shastra also says, if you don't engage in the service of Krishna, then you'll go to hell. and you'll be punished for your sinful activities. So in the beginning, there's also fear that arises from the words of Shastra. Awe and reverence and some fear in the beginning. The second kind of Shraddha, transcendental Shraddha, is called Bhagwat Lila Madhuri Lobha Mayi Shraddha. That is faith in the words of Guru Sadhu and Shastra, which come by the great mercy of having the association of pure devotees, rasika devotees, as Srila Gurudev just said. That is, those devotees who are tasting all mellow relationships with Krishna, those who are experiencing transcendental sentiments, and those who are tattvajna, that is, who's realized all tattvas, maya tattva, jiva tattva, bhagavat tattva, praying tattva, he's realized them all. And hearing the sweet pastimes of the Lord, one develops a lobe or a greed for following the inhabitants of Braja, who particularly are oceans of the mood which is in my heart, which is in my swarup, which is in my constitutional position. And then under the guidance of that saintly sadhu, I gradually hear those pastimes, hear the qualities of the Lord, and advance in bhakti by that way. So this is some few words about Shraddha.
Very good. Thank you.
But from where this Shraddha will come? Transcendental Shraddha. This is the question. So Bhakti Sat may speak two words.
Once, in Melbourne, Australia, one devotee asked our Guru Maharaj, Nijalila Pravishta Om Vishnupad, Isi Bhaktivinoda Swami Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada, from where did we get the good fortune to get your association? We actually didn't know the Sanskrit word sukriti, good fortune. But he said it anyway like that. Prabhupada looked at him and said, you didn't have any. I brought it for you. In the Shastra it says, sadhu sanga, sadhu sanga, sarva shastra koi. Sarva sanga, sarva matra, sarva siddhi hoi. Lava matra, sarva siddhi hoi. When something is necessary to be heard, it's repeated. So here we hear sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sarva shastra koi. This means all scriptures are shouting one thing, get the association. Sa anga means with the limbs or the body of, get close to a sadhu. Who is a sadhu? What is a sadhu? That means one who can give us that which is sad, eternal, the truth, the absolute truth. And he can give us the sadhan, the practice that we're going to need to get to that truth. And he's going to give us the sadhya, which is the goal of that practice. One poet has sung, if you don't know where you're going, any road will get you there. So we see this sometimes in devotees, because they don't have a clear or fixed conception of what is their goal in Krishna consciousness. Their practices are all over the map. They don't have any clear idea of how to do bhajan or how to do sadhana, practices of bhakti, with what goal or mood in mind. So these things are given by a real bona fide sadhu, and therefore we want, without him we cannot get the mercy of God. Once I asked Srila Gurudev, how is the mercy of God coming to us? As like the cat or the monkey in the Ramanuja Sampradaya. Do we hold on to Guru and he carries us there? Or does he pick us up like a mother cat picks up the kitten and he carries us there? He said, both are required. He said, it is like the Guru is throwing down the rope of his instructions to you who are stuck deep in a well and you can't get out. So you're going to have to grab hold of that rope, but he's also going to pull you out. So both are required. Some effort will be required on our part. Sometimes, in very rare cases, Guru may also come down into that well and lift you out. Like sometimes somebody who never graduated from high school because for some reason he will get an honorary degree from Harvard. But will that happen to everyone? No, that is very, very rare. So we should not think, oh, I won't do anything and Guru will come and save me. We should also be merciful to Guru and make some efforts on our part. So we will talk this week about all these subject matters, and I thank Gurudev for calling on me and hope that he was satisfied. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
So, in Sadhu Sangha, if we can know without the help and surrender in the Lord's feet of Sadguru, we cannot attain the bhakti. Thus knowing this, he is such any guru, bona fide guru. But if he has not done Sukriti there, oh very God, very rare. Kotis of Imahamne and millions of millions person, very rare, that can have a bona fide. So, knowing this, he began to search. And if he had lot of Sukriti, then any Vaishnava will tell, oh come with me, I will let you, I will help you and I will take you to bona fide. Oh, he is my Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Oh, he is my guru. Anyone took Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Abhay Charanar Prabhu? Oh, he was searching and one day anyone took him to Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta. And then he saw, in a glance he was attracted to him. And he surrendered. So this is one way. Then he takes Harinam first. And he promises that I should not take I will follow four reflective principles. And Gurudev gives Harinam. After serving him so many years, then he takes, he thinks the necessity of taking Diksha, Tibdekhya. Then he takes Rishit Diksha. And thus his bhajan kriya begins, serving him like bosom friends and having some lines from Gurudev. He begins bhajan and gradually Anant goes. This is the line or way, process to give up all the anas. If a man is always in Anant, how he can develop his Krishna consciousness? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in the first of Yam, that is in first beginning, he is telling Parama Pamana Krishna. This is Bhajan Rahasya. If you want to know all these things, you can read Bhajan Rahasyam and Jaiva Dharma. Jaiva Dharma is very important. We should try to distribute Jaiva Dharma to all devotees. Who are devotees or non-devotees. By reading this Jaiva Dharma, anyone can be a devotee. I think that this is most important. Before Bhajan Rahasya, Jaiva Dharma is needed. So I want that also, or collect that Jaiva Dharma and distribute everywhere. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling, explaining one slok of Bhakti Rasami Sindhu. Tang ne vyajam bhajagunanithim pavan pavananam Shraddharajyan iti uttam slokamaulim Pruddhanantah karnakuhare hant jannamubhano Abhaso api chapayati mahapapu bhantarashi. The name of Krishna name, very powerful, very, very powerful. Even not pure name, even Namabhas, glimpse, but no. If anyone doing all kinds of Mahapatak, and all sins they go. So Nam, Krishna, pure Nam you will give, you pure Krishna praying. But Namabhas will not. Anath may go by chanting Namabhas. So he is good fine. And he told in Bhaktivinoda Thakur, for Parama Pavana Krishna Taharcha. Krishna is what? Param Pavitra. Supreme Deity. By being sincere and surrendering onto his lotus feet with a Shraddha that we explain, you should do bhajan, practice of bhakti yoga. Oh, the name of powerful Krishna is such powerful that even the Namabhas, he can take away all kinds of Mahasin, Mahapap, Sin and all other things. All kinds of anas. You should have a strong belief in this and chant. There is a book written by Sikh Shastak by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. There are 8 slokas. And very, very important. This is the essence of all the Vedas, Upanishads, and even Srimad Bhagavatam. In this Sikh Shastaka, first is Cheto Darpanamarjanam Bhav Mahatabhadi Sreya Kairava Chandrika Abhutam. Second slok, Nam Nam Akari Bhavdhan Yasarvasha. Oh, Krishna is himself name, more he has manifested his all powers, mercy in these names. But we have no belief. We want to be happy by other means. And then third is Trinadapi Sune. This is the process. And then giving up all these things, material desire. And then Na dhanam na janam. I don't want anything, position or wealth or office. I have to keep only valli. That's why punsang parujan dharma. So this bhakti. Continue must do. By body, mind and soul. Even by words, by rati, we should serve Krishna. To please him, not for our any desire, to please him, to please him. Then it will be bhakti. But pure bhakti will be uttama bhakti when it is not covered with gyan, karma, yoga and others. And no worldly desire. Anya vilashita. Then it will be uttama, otherwise no. And this uttama bhakti up to radhika madana khabhav. This. So in this asta, then after that, so in this sikshasta ke kahe krishna lila karam, iha te bhajan krame lila rupam. If you will follow this slope of sikshasta, then Krishna Leela will inspire in your heart, will come. It will manifest. So first, you should practice first sloka of Sikshastra told by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Cheto Darpana, this is. And then come to Dvitiya Sloka. What is Dvitiya Sloka? Then Na Mercy will come. And then four sloka. First, second, third, fourth. And then fifth will come what? Ainandatam. What is this? Oh, very high class of this state. At that time you can meditate your Siddhade. You know Siddhade? Or transcendental form, which is in our consultational transcendental form. Very beautiful thing is it. Anyone of Braja, like Sakha or Sakhi. And by that body, transcendentally, you can serve Radha, Krishna and Radha. Otherwise not. When you have washed away all your anats, Cheto Darpan Marjanam, Bhav Mahadag Namani Nirvapan, all kinds of anat has gone away. Washed away. Sreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam. Oh. The mercy of Krishna is like moon. It gives a nectar of rays by which all kinds of flowers. What? And so much nectar comes that all we want that. What is this? It is compared. All kinds of raya, all kinds of favorable of bhakti will come. All qualities will come in you, in third stage. And then, Shreya Kairava Chandrika, Vitaranam, Vidyavadu Jeevanam. Then what is Vidyavadu Jeevanam? This name is Badhu, most beloved of Krishna. Who is Badhu? Radhika. And her mood is highest. Prem in her, then it may come. Then at that time you can realize, oh, what is the worship that is. So in fifth sloka it has been told. If no Siddhade, no Radha Padasha, you cannot attain high class of love. So here it tells me, I sloka. Siddha Dehe Radha Padash. If you continue in this way, your sadhana and bhajan, your practice of bhakti yoga, then in fifth sloka, Ainanda Tanuja Kengaram, Patitam Ma Vishame Bhavan Dhau, Kripayato Pad Pankajas Dhuli. Dhuli means minute. And the minute dust of Radhika, lotus feet of Krishna. Same thing. And that is Siddhadeva. But very beautiful, very sweet, attractive, like gurus. That then we can chant, remember our Siddhadeva. Then Astakari Lila will come. Otherwise, not. If anyone forcibly, he is remembering his Siddhasarup, not having this estate, even no, anartha has not gone. But if he thinks that I am Radha Dasi Bhuti, then he can. Then he will be Sahaji Haribam. So I am warning you all that you should all obey Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Because his realized soul, his Gadadhar Pandit, the power of Krishna. It's the manifestation. I know that all likes to be a gopi very soon, in the beginning. Even is full of aparadha or nartha, but they want to be very gopi, especially. Oh, don't try. You should know this is your goal. And wait, all these things. And then when you will come in that state, then automatically, if your heart will be pure, and there will be mercy of your Gurudev, at once that Siddhadev will come in your heart. Then very easily, by that purified Siddhadev, transcendental Siddhadev, you can serve Radha and Krishna 8 pastimes. Otherwise, no, don't do anything for. Wait for this, and then it will come. No, you should know that. Oh, this is our aim. That's all. And begin from Shraddha and all. Chhayadi. Chhaya shlok bhajite anartha gyaran. Now, 6. Nainam galadas sudareya badanam gadagadarut dhyagira ulkarni chitang vapuhakada tavanam grahani. What is the meaning? Oh, one Kirtan Krishna Das.
बोलिए वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय जय श्री राधे गोविंद बोलो हरि गोपाल बोलो गोविंद गोविंद बोलो हरि गोपाल बोलो Go!
come up with Vrinda Vrindavan. When I will go there. I was telling about Nainam Gata Das Sudharaya Badanam Gata Gata Rudhaya. When a day will come, O Krishna, O Gurudev, when a day will come, then for you I will weep bitterly. Like a river current. Nainam Gata Das Badanam Gata Gata like Jaja Gaga Kiki not Krishna. My wife is choked. Badanam Gata Gata Rukhaya Gira Ulakai Nikita. All hair will stand. Sometimes rolling down on the earth. At that time I will not be able to chant Hare Krishna. Kri 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 like that. Jajaga Mahaprabhu. When that day will come? Automatically it will come by the process that we told. When Siddha Day will be realized, and then you will feel separation from Krishna or Radhika, then all will come automatically. Understand what I told?
He said that when that day will come, when tears will come from the eyes and torrents of rain, when the voice will be choked, when the fears of the body will stand on end, when that day will come,
why not?
He said that Gurudev said
that that day will come. When, by mercy of Gurudev, that one receives one siddhadev, when one has achieved that state, the fifth stage, Ainanda Tanuja Kinkaram Patitam Man Vishatme Pabangudam. This is the stage of Asakti. Then one will get some glimpse of one's eternal spiritual form, one siddhadev. Then at that point, by mercy of Guru, then automatically, then these symptoms of divine love, they will manifest.
Then we can feel separation sometime. And in separation, automatically we will weep, hair standing, voice choked. Don't try to do artificial all these things. Otherwise, bhakti may go. She cannot tolerate that you should imitate anything. Try to bring all these things, naturally all these things. To stay. Otherwise, you will be called Sahajiya. This is Sahajiya. That a stage not has come, but we are posing that, oh, we have achieved this. No, weeping coming, separation from Radha and Krishna. But we sometimes, by ladies, very easily they can weep and at once they can laugh and they can cut it. Anything they can do. They are like mothers. Oh, very love and affection. But sometimes they may become like Durga Kali. So, we should always remind this. Bhakti is very kumal. So in Bhaktivinoda Swami Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami has told that if you have received Sri Krishna name Mahamantra and the months will give you relation, will give relation with Krishna, transcendental Krishna, then by this diksha, they have taken. They will have to follow daily at the nick of time. Also, name also.
Don't try to waste your any moment of your life. Give whole energy. Then how to maintain our life? Oh, it will be easily. Very easy. Have faith in them and demons. Even they can support and nourish Brahma and Shankar. Oh, why not to us? So, Bhakti Goswami Sindhu is telling Srila Rupa Goswami, Sadharma, Sadharma Shyava Bodhaya, Jesham Nirbandhani Mati, this is 31 slok. Achirat Eva Sarvartha Siddheti, Esham Abhikshita. By Harinam, we can achieve everything. Whole desires will be fulfilled, even all kinds of transcendental, paramarthic, even the dasya of Krishna and Radhika can be achieved. Then can. Krishnanam dhara aneka swarupa. Namatuva aneka swarupa. Jasodanandana Anandabaradhan Prematanaya Rasa Kupa Nandatanaya Rasa Kupa. Oh, very nice. Radhadhan, Gopikam, Radhadhan, Rashtihari. Oh, so nice. Very powerful. More than anything. So now can get all these things. With such a strong belief, nishtha, we should chant name with sattva. Then, oh, we can have that thing. Pure name will come, otherwise not. And then very soon you can love, attend, oh Krishna name. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling, explaining, what is Nirbandhani Mati? What Nirbandhani, you know? Nirbandhani, Nishyatma Buddhi. What is? Those who have a strong desire, Nirbandhani Mati, sometimes, something like that. If you want to know what is our sadharma, what is our love and goal of our love and affection, if they know, they follow that process. And what is that thing? They should take Tulasi Mala, initiated by Gurudev in Mahamantra, and after that, 8 kinds of mantra, Guru Mantra, Guru Gayatri, Gaur Mantra, Guru Gayatri, Krishna Mantra, Ram Gayatri, Panchatattva and Harina. Then what you should do? Don't neglect any day. With strong belief, you should daily do at time.